Hello guys, this is Sushant. So welcome to your channel that is Sci Engineers. It's been a long time since our last meet. So as promised, I have brought this particular video in which we will be discussing about the field of engineering. So many of you guys would be waiting for your exam results of your 12th standard, and also some of you would be waiting for your 10th standard results also. So all the best for that. So before we begin, let us try to understand what is engineering basically is. So engineering is nothing but it is a study, a field of study in which we'll be understanding the concepts of mathematics and its application and physics, along with the various branches of sciences, along with the economic, social and practical knowledge to invent, to innovate, to maintain a particular system, to do research on a particular system, and to improve on that particular system. So engineering is all about this. So it is basically to make a new thing, to maintain that particular thing, and to innovate a particular thing. Now to understand this particular definition, let us take a very, very rough example of a chair which you are sitting upon. This particular chair, if you go 50 years back, it would have a different design, a different structure to it. And 50 years hence, it will have a different structure to it. So this is only possible because of various engineering concepts which are being applied on this chair. Now, there is also a change in the material of the chair. There is also redesigning of a chair. You can see various chairs in different designs which are available in the market. And also you can see various chairs in the market which have been implemented to do various facilities like massaging your body, etc., changing of the temperature of the chair and all those things. So you can see that various concepts on that particular simple chair has been applied. Now once you have understood that particular example, what you can see is that engineering basically is touching each and every aspects of your life. It goes from a simple basic needs like food, shelter and clothing to the major things like space technology. So it is having a vast spectrum on which it is having its impact. Now let us try to understand what are the various fields which are related to engineering. Now as I just said, engineering is a vast field of sciences. So it is very difficult to bifurcate engineering into bits and pieces. In general, we can bifurcate engineering into these four categories, that is your civil engineering, chemical engineering, mechanical engineering and electrical engineering. Now just to give a rough idea what each engineering is. Now if we consider civil engineering, it is one of the oldest engineering which is present. Basically in civil engineering, you will be building your buildings, your structures, various structures like bridges. People who are living in Mumbai might have seen the Worli ceiling, which is one of the engineering marvels which is present in India. The steel cables which are used in the construction of that particular bridge are said to be of the length of the circumference of the earth. So you can see that it is one of the engineering marvels which is present. Coming to the next one, we have the chemical engineering. So chemical engineering, as the name suggests, it is related to chemistry. Mostly it is related to chemistry. Now in the chemical engineering, there are other fields which are related to it, like petroleum and gas industry, the pharmaceutical industry, etc. The third major field which we have is the mechanical engineering. Now mechanical engineering, it can be also considered as the oldest field which is present, because while the construction of various wonders of the world like the pyramids in Egypt and also the Harappa civilization, the use of mechanical components were used, like the application of the fulcrum, the use of the pulley, etc. So it is basically the understanding of the various mechanical components and the interaction of those components with each other. Now the last major field is our electrical engineering. This particular engineering can be considered as the newest or the youngest member in the group, because this particular engineering had its major impact only after the invention of electricity. Now because of electrical engineering, all the other fields are also affected because of it. The expansion in the electrical field has affected all the other fields also. In electrical engineering, there are various sub-fields which have shown advancement in the last 2-3 decades, like the computer engineering, the electronics engineering, and the electronics telecommunication industry. Now, because of the vast expansion in the various engineering fields, we can see that there has been interlink of various fields with each other. Like you can see various combinations of electrical engineering with the mechanical engineering, which has resulted into a field, separate field, which is called as a mechatronics engineering. Now, in mechatronics engineering, it is basically comprising of the mechanical engineering, the electronics engineering, and the communication engineering. Now, after we have understood the various fields of engineering, let us try to understand how does one get into a field of engineering or the engineering curriculum. Now, the first most popular way in which you can enter into an engineering curriculum is by doing your 12th standard, which most of you might have gone through. Now, to get into it, you require an engineering entrance exam test, which can be organized on a state level or a national level. Now, currently, one of the centralized exam tests which we have is the JEE, which most of the state and accept it as an entrance test exam. Now, the second way in which you can enter into an engineering curriculum is by doing your 10th standard and then joining a diploma course for engineering, which is basically the polytechnical institutes. You have to join that, and after completion of that diploma course, you have to give an entrance exam test by which you can directly enter into your second year of engineering. Now, let us try to understand the number of years which are required for either of the ways. Now, when you're doing your 12th standard, you'll be requiring 2 years, that is your 11th and 12th standard. And then after entering into an engineering institute, you will normally take 4 years for completion of it. So basically, you will require a total of 6 years. Now, if you are going by this way, after 10th, you will be joining a diploma course. The diploma course is mostly of 3 years. And you're after entering into an engineering stream. Now, whenever you're doing your diploma course and you have successfully given your entrance test and you have acquired a seat, you will be getting admission into the second year of engineering. So you don't have to do 1 year of engineering. So basically, after 3 years of diploma, you will be doing 3 years of engineering degree course. So basically, you will be requiring a total of 6 years only. So you can see that in either of the way, you require a 6 years normally. Now, there are many courses in diploma also which are of 4 years, because there is an added year which is your industrial training. Now, whenever you're getting into a diploma course, you have to make sure how many years are required. Normally, it is 3 years, but some of the colleges do have it as a 4-year course, which is having an added industrial training as one of the year. Now, these are the 2 ways in which you can enter the engineering, which are the most popular. There is a third way in which you can enter, that is you're done with your 10th and also your 12th. After this, you can enter into a diploma course. Now, while entering into a diploma course, you can enter it into the second year of diploma. So, after you're getting into a second year of diploma, you can then give the entrance test after completion of the diploma course, and then you can get into a degree college. Now, when you're getting into a second year of diploma, you require to understand that it will be only possible if there are vacancies remaining in the polytechnical institutes. So these, in the second year, if there is any vacancy available in the polytechnical institute, then only you can enter into the second year. For 12th standard, you will be requiring 2 years. When you are getting into a diploma course, you will be having an added 2 years because you are not attending the first year of diploma. And then after diploma, you will be having 3 years of degree. So basically, you will be requiring a minimum 7 years of engineering to complete, to get the engineering degree. So these are the various ways in which you can enter. Of these are the two popular ones. Now there are some advantages and disadvantages in both of them, that the first two one. The mathematics section, when you're going by your 12th standard, is relatively a more stronger than going by this way. Because in diploma, you'll be studying mathematics for only 1.5 years, that is your first year, and half of the second year only. And the remaining section, that is the remaining 1.5 years, you won't be access to mathematics. So that becomes a disadvantage over there. So most of the diploma holders are weak in mathematics because the concepts are not clear, which are being cleared in the 12th standard. Now the advantage in the second way is, while doing your diploma, you have been in touch with the technical knowledge. Most of the diploma students are very good in their technical knowledge because they have gone through the practical experience. Like if you are doing your electronics engineering, they would know what are the various components present, how to identify the components and all those things. But in that case, if you go and look in the 12th standard, if you're not taking your vocational subjects, you won't be having any technical knowledge as such. People who are going for any of these ways, you have to just look into the advantages, disadvantages, and there have been many people who go by the diploma way also, because this gives an added edge. Now in the third way, the disadvantage is that it requires 7 years for completion of your engineering. Now the next important thing which you should know is this degree which you will be getting from the institute which you are joining for your engineering. That is your BE and a BTech degree. Now technically there is no difference, there is very small difference, minute difference between them. If you just look at the acronym for this, it's basically Bachelor of Engineering for BE, and for BTech it is Bachelor of Technology. Now actually in BE there is more emphasis given on the theoretical part of engineering, and in BTech it's more emphasis on the practical part of it. But if you see the syllabus for both of them, they are running parallel to each other. So basically there is no change in the syllabus which is mentioned in either of this. So there is no difference as such between Bachelor of Engineering and Bachelor of Technology. The only difference which matters is the institute which you are joining. Most of the institutes like our IITs, which are basically the topmost institutes of our country, if you are getting a BTech degree from there, so obviously the BTech from that particular institute holds more than any of the BE which you are doing from any other institute. But if you are in the assumption that a BTech degree is superior than BE, so that's not actually the case. It depends on the institute, just as I said. So whenever you're getting into an institute, engineering institute, it is a must to understand what type of institute it is. We'll be discussing those things when we are doing our cap round sections of the videos, in which I'll be discussing the various institutes which are present, how to basically bifurcate the institute while filling the cap round forms and all those things. Now the next topic which you should understand is what you can do after engineering. Now after engineering, obviously you will be searching out for jobs. So jobs will be related to what field you have taken up. Like if you are doing your computers, you will be getting into a IT field or a Microsoft companies like Microsoft and all those. If you are doing electronics, then you will be going into that particular field. But engineering as such, you can enter into any other fields if they have that particular requirement. Like a mechanical engineer can also enter into an IT field if the company is based on mechanical industry. Like companies like TCS, which cover up most of the engineering fields in their IT sector. So they do require engineers from different fields also. Now, apart from jobs, if you are going for further studies, the further studies which can be done after your graduation is your master's. You can do your ME or your M.Tech, which is mostly done in India. You can get into an institute which is giving you ME or M.Tech. The difference again remains the same, that is between BE and BTech. The other option which you can go is, if you are willing to go abroad, that is doing your MS, you can go for US, Europe countries, etc. Also in countries like Singapore, they do provide a degree in M.Tech in their institutes. So you can just go through it when you're at that particular level. Now it is just an introduction to it. So these are the things which you can do your further studies, or you can get into a direct PhD program. If you are interested in research, then you can enter into a PhD program which can be done just after your bachelor's, which is being provided in various IITs also. So those are the various things which you can do after engineering. The other most popular way which many people go for is doing their MBA. So getting into an MBA, they can go into the financial sector and various other sectors which are related to this. So we will be wrapping up with this particular video section. Please do share in your comment what more do you want to know about the engineering curriculum. Also, we will be uploading videos on various fields, making you more understand what that particular field is based on. Also, do point out what are the things you would like to know about various fields. Please do comment in the comment section below. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe to our channel. If you want us to emphasize on any of the topic which we have taken in this video, please do let us know. I would like to tell you guys that we also take group tuitions for first and second year engineering. If you are in your science, that is 11th and 12th, we also conduct classes for that. For inquiry, you can visit our Facebook page on which you can get the required details of us. So till then, take care, keep learning, keep watching, and happy learning. Bye.